council list. Just access this a bit.
So good morning, everybody. So today I will present MedSearch, a specialized search engine for medical information retrieval. So actually, most of the internet user does not know about medical terminology, or what if he feels something, what he should search, what phrase he have to use. So this is the problem actually. What he does, he want to write everything, means his symptom, his present situation, or past medical history in plain English. So in web page, there is if you get useful information, then you have to give some medical terminology, medical phrase, then you will get more better result. So when he writes his symptom, his present situation, his past medical history, it becomes very long. That query becomes very long. So in traditional medical search engine or traditional web search engine does not handle those long query. So what MedSearch handle that long query efficiently, and it gives some suggest that user some medical phrase, or what should he do next. This is so we'll next see how a MedSearch can help a patient to enter his treatment. So how MedSearch can help a patient? Actually, using MedSearch, he can preliminary diagnostic, self-diagnostic. He can do preliminary self-diagnostic, and before going to doctor, he can prepare him what he will ask to doctor and everything. And when he goes during that time of appointment, every doctor does not tells everything, means he does not clear everything. So after coming back home, he can use that MedSearch to clarify what that doctor told. And even when he went to doctor, but doctor even did not clarify something, then he got puzzled. Then he can clarify his symptom, what is happening, and what should he do. Mainly, this is the user interface of MedSearch. Actually, MedSearch has two interfaces. One is query interface, and another is answer interface. Query interface in traditional website engine, what happens, it accepts small query. So it has only one text box, one line text box. But MedSearch, what it accepts is long query. So its query interface contains a multi-line text box, and another interface is answer interface. It's two part. The second part is answer interface. In like traditional web search engine, it also returns number of result pages. Like you can see here, 1, 2, 3, like that one. So in every result page, it shows 10 elements, and that 10 element, each element contains this part, title, some snippets and URL of that page. And in that interface, in right side, it suggests related medical phrase which that user can use to define his query to get better results. Now, main challenge is with respect to other regular search engine is in user actually does not familiar with medical terminology, and he does not know exact what he should write. So he writes everything and in plain English. So it becomes long, and this type of query MedSearch handle successfully and efficiently. So these are the steps which use MedSearch to process the query. First step is remove stop words, then it rewrites that long query into moderate length. After that, it produces that result pages and then generate snippets to return to the user and suggest some medical phrases. So it uses traditional standard stop word removal technique to remove stop word. So they did not need anything new, and is the query rewriting long query into small moderate length. So what it does actually, why you need this one actually, in traditional web search engine, what it does it consider all those web pages which contains all term of the query. And another method they can use, only those considers all those web pages which contains at least one of the term of query. So as this query is very long, we cannot get many page, means almost none, which contains all the term. So MedSearch use that second method. But second method, it have to modify that one, because if it considers intersection of union of those all the pages, then it have to process all the web pages. So it does second, it use this second method in following. This is the problem using second method if we do not modify anything. Means it has to process all web pages, and that inverted list for each term, to traverse it will take much time. So what it does, in traditional medical search engine, use first one, second one, like this, it impose that query length, like in like Google Help was there, now it is not there. In 2013 they discontinued that one, and one is another is Healthline is another med search engine. So in Google Health they imposed only 20 word per query. When it exceeds, it truncates that one. And in Healthline they restrict that one is in 32 word. But that is not feasible because we want to allow much more information to give search engine. Another way they can use means they can ask searcher to drop the terms which is unimportant. But that is also not feasible because that searcher does not know which word is important, which word is unimportant, because a term important is depends on its distribution in whole corpus or all the web pages. So this is also not feasible. But another solution, if we do automatically identify and if we automatically identify unimportant term and from long query and drop them, that is feasible, more feasible. And Mesas use that one, and it uses that Okapi formula to automatically identify and drop this long query, drop the term, unimportant term from long query. This is Okapi formula they use. It actually calculate the relevance of document, ranking to be used to ranking the document. So this is the formula, standard formula, so we cannot discuss this one. So this is the steps what it used to re-rating this query. Suppose these many terms, distinct term is Q have, this is the query. Now first we define a threshold to differentiate this is short query, this is long query. This LT is, suppose LT is that threshold. In med search default value of LT is 10. What it does, if the query length is less than 10, it does not do anything. It removes stop word and directly search. If it is greater than 10, then it rewrites that query. How it will do that one? It calculate the TA by DF value of all the query terms using that Okapi formula. And which term has low TA by DF value, it will drop that one. And how much it will drop? We have to, any means system administrator can that set that upper bound U. Upper bound U, and it keep those many term is a minimum of U and norm of Q into P. Or P is the constant, like 90%, 70%. Whichever minimum, they will keep as many terms. So next is, we have to diversify that search result, because um, otherwise we will get only related, only some almost related medical pages. So we have to diversify the result. How it does means it massage, what it will do, it does clustering method, in offline clustering method. It uses k-means to cluster those all the collections, and suppose we have to return that j many web pages, then it will take j web pages from j cluster with largest relevance score, and the relevance score is calculated using that OPAMI problem. So next is generating snippet. Medsearch use standard passage retrieval technique to generate snippet, and for each snippet it highlights that medical phrases and top three common term between that query and that SN. Means SN means that snippet. Now as I told you that why you need that medical phrase. Actually, to refine that query, we need this medical phrase. If search are the more important term, more medical phrase, then you will get better result. So now this is the method to search suggest that medical phrase. It has two step. It first generates that set, candidate set, and then rank that set, so that searcher can identify this one is very important, this one is very important. Likewise. So, generating medical phrase should be top ranked from coming from top web pages, and it should be diverse. So it should be diverse means it should not come from a single web page. It should come from many other web pages from that set of medical phrases. So what we does we do that continuous discounting method to achieve this. What it does, suppose one medical phrase is selected from a web page, what we will do, we will give some discount of all other web pages, of all other medical term from that web page, so that we can select other medical term from other web page. So next is we have to rank those medical phrases to be present to the user. What we can do TF-IDF method and the relevance score method. But TF-IDF method is not always satisfactory, because with the largest TF-IDF method, the largest TF-IDF value, that medical phrase may not be relevant to the query. So what method use is relevance score method. It is reasonable, but not, implementation is not straightforward, because that query is written in plain English, and that that mapping is not straightforward, means medical phrase is not there in query. So what we can do, we can translate that query into medical terminology, and that we can translate that medical terminology to plain English. But that first one is not so feasible, so MedSearch use that second one to it translate medical phrase to plain English. And how it does this one? It converts each medical phrase to our representative web pages, and it calculates that relevance, that query relevance score between the query and that representative web pages, and it takes that average of that score, and that represents the relevance score of that that medical phrase. After that, in last step, we sort that medical phrase according to their relevance score and give that output. So this is comparison with two other search engine, Google Help and Healthline. You can see this Google Help here, that query length limit is 32 words, and for Healthline, I don't know, I think it is opposite. I missed that one, maybe. And MedSearch has no query length limit, and Google Health considers only those web pages which contains all the term of the query, so it does not give a good result, almost zero result. And Healthline considers that at least one term in given query, but it has that query length limit. And MedSearch also consider all the web pages which has at least one term count. Google Health does not perform that result diversification. Healthline also does not perform that result diversification, but MedSearch is that one. So among these three, MedSearch is better. So this is metric which they use to judge that result. We have to judge both relevance and diversity, and they use that usefulness. What is usefulness? It is defined as score. Usefulness score is 1 if it is relevant to the query, and usefulness score is 0 if it is not relevant. And for top 20 web pages, we have to calculate that just using this formula to average score, to find that average score. So now MedSearch use that many parameters like upper bound of query length, means modified query, upper bound of modified query length. So it is the graph for comparison of upper bound of modified query length and that returned web pages usefulness score. Left one is that one, and it is usefulness score of medical phrase. Here we can see that when upper bound is low, then usefulness is low, but when upper bound is 80, then usefulness is highest. What? Why is this? Because when the value of U is less low, then small, then much information it does not contain. So usefulness is scored become low. And when it is its value is large, then it contains some irrelevant term into that query. So again, it deteriorates that result. So between 70 to 100, it is good result. It gives good result. This is another graph for processing time versus that query length. When this horizontal line is represent when there is no that query processing method. It is it takes much time, but when that value of U is low, then it takes small time. We can see when that value of U is 80, then it takes some 0.6 or like that, which is almost 40% of that when that query rating process is not there. So now it is a graph when we use that number of cluster in pre-processing method. Here we can see when number of cluster is low, then that usefulness score is low, because it almost all related web pages try to go into one cluster, one or related cluster, then we cannot get the diversified result, so its usefulness become low. And when this cluster number is very high, then also it does not mean anything. Means if you take large number of cluster, then almost all are scattered. The default value of k is in med search is 1500, and there it got highest result. So this is graph. This is technique one is when query rating method is there. Technique two, when pre-clustering is there. And technique three, when relevance score is used to rank the highest medical phrase. And we can see if this is this result is baseline result, and when technique one is not there, this result is there. It is for returned web page, and right one is for returned medical phrase. In both, we can see when all the technique are there, then we get the highest result in both the cases. So we have to use these all three techniques which we discussed earlier. So this is the experimental result for return top 20 web pages and highest 60 medical pages, which search perform 30% improvement in weighted average of usefulness score in return web pages according to the baseline, and 44% improvement in returning that medical suggested medical phrases. So this is the strength of med search engine. It accepts extended query length, extended length query, and it supports use of plain English description. It automatically rewrites that long query into moderate length. It provides that diversified search result, and it tries to diversify and related medical queries to quickly digest that search result to and refine the query. Actually, they did not wrote anything about their weakness, but I thought these two may be their weakness. It does not provide that questionnaire based query interface with built-in medical terminology where we can write question and they give some answer. They does not provide that one, and they actually does not provide any treatment suggestion. They suggest that medical phase, but what actually we should do, they does not suggest anything. So this is the paper. CIKM 2008. Thank you.
Okay. So then of course we'll have questions. Go to the beginning. Okay. Slowly. Next. Okay, next. So this one is a copy thing. Intuitively, any so what is it? How different is it from TFID? Or try to figure it out.
Actually, they use that TFID bit.
It is TFID framework. So, like, you know, how is it similar or different from TFID? Basically, it's a probabilistic weighting. They proved some things and with. In the trick competitions, Okapi actually performed better than other scoring mechanisms towards the beginning of 2000 and so on. And yeah, I remember using this as well. Okay, so basically, yeah, it's kind of TFID, but it's just different kind of, bit more complicated. It's hard to explain in a simple with a simple intuition. Okay, go forward. Forward. Okay, hold on. So here, what you are saying is, for all terms in Q, their TFID values roughly reflect their importance. TFID values in what? So TFID of a term is attached to a document. TFID of a term in a document, right? What do you mean by a term in a query? TFID values roughly reflect their importance. So. So
suppose one document, we have to calculate
this is happening before you even fetch the documents, right? Before you actually search. So I guess what they might be doing is IDF of terms are, you know, already there. And the TF is just the TF in that query, because query is so long. Then think of that as a document. Maybe that is what they're doing.
Okay, well, I will check that.
I mean, this TFIDF in terms of a copy, but maybe they are just considering the query as a document and the TFID of the term, I mean that whatever score in the query.
Maybe.
Because query is so long, if the query is 4 words, then it don't make sense because typically term frequency will be 1 only. Then you're basically just
IDF will be across queries or for
double? IDF will be across corpus.
You have to pre-compute it. But how can you? Yeah, so basically that's what I guess what they're doing.
Actually, I did not thought earlier that one.
Okay, then go next. Okay, so all the return top J web pages belong to a different cluster. So how is that done? Go next. Passage retrieval technique to generate a snippet. Okay, fine, that's okay. Okay, that's fine. Go next. Okay, continuous discounting is fine, we understood. Go next. Okay, why is this? Often unsatisfactory due to medical phrases with the largest TFID value may not be related to the query. What do you mean by that?
Actually, in query, that medical phrase is not there. And if we calculate that TFID value, largest TFID value, that may not be.
Okay. So in that query, it may not have a. Okay, reasonable is the relevant score method. Okay. Translating given to medical terminology. Okay, then next. Each medical phrase includes R representative web pages where R is a constant. Okay, medical phrase come to weighted average of relevance scores in the name reference. So how is this possible? I mean, how is this done? So a medical phrase, how can you convert into representative web pages?
That medical phrase, what it means, the rights into a web page. In different way means if R is 2 or 3, like that, they write in different way that medical phrase. And then they calculate that as four relevance.
What do you mean representative web page?
Suppose we have a medical phrase, medical term.
Okay.
It means something. We wrote this in different way in 2 or 3 web pages.
And how do you know that?
That is done by some expert, means they wrote some.
No, but you don't have that chance, right? It's online. So query has come. Or it's like done beforehand, or?
It is
done beforehand.
Done beforehand.
The set of medical phrases is fixed.
Yeah.
Total set of medical phrases.
Okay.
Fixed.
Okay. Fine. Go next.
Okay. This is fine. Okay. Go next.
Weighted average usefulness score. Weighted average usefulness score, query element of the bound. Okay, weighted average usefulness score versus U web page and medical phrase. Okay, usefulness score of web page, usefulness score of medical phrase. Okay, fine. So 80 seems optimal in both cases. Okay, then go. What is this 1.5, just below 1.5? I don't understand that.
Actually, 1.5 is when that query rating method is not there, it is. Taking this much time.
It's constant.
It's constant, I don't know. I prefer that one. Why they gave that straight line.
Okay.
And they just wrote that one. The horizontal line is describing that when that query writing method is not there.
Okay, so if you don't rewrite the query and shorten it, then you have take more time. Okay, that time. And go next. Maybe there's an average. Okay. So it is k number of clusters. So does it mean that there are 1,500 types of medical combinations that you can have?
Means that the related document.
So it really means there are 1,500 types of diseases you can have.
Something like that.
Okay, go on next. Okay. Okay, next.
I don't know where they got that baseline case.
Okay, okay, next. Okay, now let's understand. So it doesn't provide questionnaire based query interface, like, you know, there are some. Is it painting?
Yes.
Is it painting on the left side or right side?
Like that.
The decision kind of. Doesn't provide a treatment suggestion. Okay, so it's basically so it's not really question answering kind of stuff. So, yeah. Okay, fine. Okay, alright. So. That's okay. You have anybody else has any question? No? Okay.
I had only confusion around the clustering.
Which confusion?
Clustering is how did they do that?
Okay. Game inside, I
guess.
So yeah, this game is.
What are the measures of this?
Oh, document clustering, so some documents in that you needed, some vector space in that, something like that. That's, I guess, I mean, they probably haven't mentioned, but it's, yeah. Okay, by the way, so some suggestions.
Listen, and diversifying things means for a search query, for a query, there might be different symptoms or something.
Right. So like, suppose you will have headache. You search with that and all the results you get are regarding migraine. But that will not be the only cause, right? So that doesn't help you. So one document should be about migraine, one should be about, you know, some other thing, one should be about some other thing. Okay, so on. That's important everywhere. So diversity research. Okay, so one suggestion is that whenever you present a paper, you must especially experimental results, you must clearly say what the data is. What the data is, you know, how big is that, what kind of documents are there. Okay, that is important. And when you present, suppose this is somebody else's paper, so they should have done that as well, but maybe they have, and you haven't put it in. When you present running time, must say the system specification, like running time on system like this, you know, so many cores, so many RAM memory, so much.
They wrote that on.
Yeah, so you have, basically whenever you present, just mention that. So that these two are essential. So what is the data? Or what, there can be several data sets. One or more data sets, whatever data sets, and you should just mention. And the running time, whenever you mention running time, you must mention. Just like you mention the measures, what are the measures, and hence the numbers. Similarly, running time is meaningless unless you mention what is the system, yeah, machine configuration. Even then, many things can differ. Somebody wrote in Python, somebody wrote in Java, somebody wrote in C. Even the code can be different and so on. But, you know, something, basically, yeah. So all the system specification, what programming language used, I mean, whatever is available, basically. Whatever you think you should mention. Okay, good, thank you. Okay, so I'm going to send you the marks for the projects and these, as well as the assignments within a couple of days maybe. And the questions will probably be more regular than even mid-sem. just a hint, like
more regular.
More regular in the sense it might even be more direct to what has been taught.
Okay.
That doesn't mean I'll tell you to write a definition, most probably, but